particular laptop is having Linux, okay, and it can still load VirtualBox. The operation is more or less same. Okay, we have loaded VirtualBox on Linux. So what does that mean? VirtualBox can be loaded on Linux. VirtualBox can be loaded on Windows. So we will show the base OS here in this laptop is Linux. So we will show Windows side by side to this. So this gives you a fairly good idea about what is virtualization. Okay? So this is the, somebody might not have actually loaded VirtualBox. So this is the interface. Okay? Just go to new. So it is asking, you can give your own name, not a problem. R typically, what is the OS you are installing? That is the name normally we give, so that it becomes easy. Okay? So he has given Windows 7. Yeah. How much of you are comfortable with 32 bit and 64 bit? Can anybody explain what is 32 bit and what is 64 bit? What is bit? I should not be asking this to a third year computer science students, but what is a bit? Please, even electronic students can also answer, and they should be able to answer. Yeah, binary digit. Okay, what is binary? No, this is very important. Don't actually smile or think that like, okay, what is this? This guy is actually taking us for a ride. Do you think this simple thing is not known to us? No, a lot of people are not aware of it. And the virtualization was possible or is possible right now because 32-bit and 64-bit has not been developed now. It has been developed long time back. Okay? DEC Alpha, 64-bit, true Unix used to be there. DEC stands for Digital Equipment Corporation, which has been acquired by Compaq. Compaq has been acquired by HP. So HP Unix, 64-bit. So 64-bit is there since almost like, to my knowledge, last 30 years. 32-bit is there. Okay? So, but the right from 2003 onwards, both Intel and AMD made it possible. Okay? 32-bit has been made as a subset of 64-bit. That means whatever the instructions that are going to be for 32-bit, you are different from 64-bit. But the engineering team of both Intel as well as AMD has made it possible. They made a subset of 32-bit into 64-bit. So whenever there is a 64-bit instruction set, it goes to 64-bit. And whenever there is a 32-bit instruction, it goes into 32-bit. So that has prompted the actual virtualization. Because 32-bit has got certain limitations. It cannot talk to RAM more than 3.8 GB or 4 GB. It cannot talk to a bigger RAM. It cannot talk to a bigger hard disk. Okay? The limitation of 32-bit is very, very harsh on the hardware. Hardware manufacturers were able to develop bigger RAMs, better RAMs, but the 32-bit operating system was not able to take it. 64-bit, technically speaking, it can talk to any amounts of RAM. Of course, there is a top limit, but it can go up to zettabytes of RAM, which maybe in our lifetime may not be using in a single machine. Okay? And similarly, hard disk also. So 64-bit has made, or the 32-bit was made into a subset of 64-bit thanks to a university effort. That is what is Zen. From Zen, when Zen was being developed, VMware was also developed. It happened in between 2002-2003. And we should be happy to note that like we are able to see the growth of all these things It is actually happening in front of our eyes. Say for example, automobiles. Automobiles has been developed almost 120 years back. We didn't know what was actually happening. What we can do is, okay, Maruti has launched a new vehicle, so better CC, better mileage, that's it. But here we can know what is actually happening. Okay? So when you actually open a magazine or something like that, Amazon has started a new service. So you know a bit about Amazon. What is this new service? Okay? So maybe you can say after 20 years, we can say that, okay, we are part of it when it was launched. We cannot say the same thing as far as automobiles is concerned. We can at most say that, okay, Maruti Swift, when it was launched, we were there. We don't know anything about that. What goes inside? But here, 64-bit, 32-bit, all these things, they are actually happening right now. You understood? So here, you can actually, one more advantage of this virtualization is, suppose you have a 64-bit OS already installed, and you want to try one of your application whether it is going to work properly on a 32-bit or not. Previously, what used to happen is, you need to load 32-bit operating system on another machine, take this application, load it, test it. But here, you can actually test it on a virtual machine. So here, XP on the monitor. See here, 1 minute. So the total RAM that is there inside that particular machine. Okay, so the total RAM is 4 GB inside that particular machine. So you can see the slider. And this, up to this, you can just drag it. That's almost like 2 GB. Beyond that, it is showing a, it's actually a red color. That means it is asking you, the base OS needs certain RAM. Please don't give beyond this. Okay?
You can give 1 GB, that's
sufficient. So we are giving 1 GB. So this is one thing. So it requires a hard disk, right? So where exactly the hard disk is going to be from our existing hardware, it is going to create a particular partition. So it is giving you three things. Do not add a virtual hard drive or create a virtual hard drive now. Okay? Use an existing virtual hard drive file. So we are going for a create a virtual hard drive now. Yeah. Please make a note of this. These are very, very important. VDI is a virtual disk image. These are the formats which are not going to change. Okay? When you are using the virtual box, that is this file, VDI. VMDK is from VMware. VHD is from Microsoft. Parallels, this is another virtualization. Parallels is a company. Okay? HDD. QED is QMO. Quick emulator. And QCOP. So these are the formats. Okay? So I'm sure everybody knows about the formats. When you type something in Word and you try to save it, in what format it is going to be saved? .doc or .docx. Right? So that is the proprietary format of Microsoft. There is some other format if you have tried it called RTF. Rich text format, which is, it's an open format. Nothing to do with Microsoft. Okay? So, if you are trying to use .doc or .docx and go to another friend's machine and try to open it, if MS Office is not there, it cannot be opened. Okay? But .rtf can be opened with even WordPad, which is going to be coming along with your Windows. Okay? You don't need MS Word or MS Office to really go through a small file which has been created by your friend. Okay? If your friend has stored it in a format which is like open format. Okay? Next. So, it is asking, it should be dynamically allocated or fixed files. What it is doing, it is if it is dynamically allocated means, you are creating a file. Okay? So that file is going to be dynamically allocation means it automatically fills it when file are the permissible file size of your operating system. If you are using 64 bit, there is a permissible limit. If you are using a 32 bit, there is a permissible limit of the file size, which you normally don't see it because we are going to use a normal file, right? Which will not be touching the extreme limits, but this will be touching the extreme limits. So be careful, you can actually put it as dynamically allocated. So it is asking generally how much should be the I should fix it. So this particular laptop has got a 2 TB hard disk. Out of that, should I put 10 GB to start with? We have given it as dynamically allocation. Dynamic allocation. That means if it is touching 11 GB also, it goes to 11 GB. But minimum to start with. Okay, it is the path. So as you can see, it has been created as windowsxp.pda. If I have given it as jntuh, it will be stored as jntuh.pdi. But after some time, we will not know what is the operating system that is inside unless we start using it again. Okay? Yeah, it is the path. Where exactly it has to be stored? Say for example, it is on the desktop or it is on the C drive, D drive. We are using Linux, so that is the reason it is showing slash MND slash Rajendra slash. It is nothing but you can treat it as C drive or D drive. Wherever you want to store it, you can store it. Okay? 1 minute. So as you can see, it is giving you a snapshot of what is the hardware, what is the software, everything. Generally, the general name is Windows XP. What is the operating system? Windows XP 32 bit. I have given it as general name as Windows XP, Windows, but I could have passed down Windows 7 64 bit also here. It is no guarantee that by based on the name, it is going to be only that. Okay? The second thing is, what is the base memory of this particular hardware? See, today, as you can see, we are creating a hardware. From where? From our machine. So it is something like out of 4 GB, we have taken 1 GB. And the second thing is boot order. If you are comfortable with the assembly, boot order plays a major role and it is going to be in BIOS. Have you ever watched it? You can actually boot from CD or from the hard disk or something like that. There is an order. So you can change this order. Right now the order has been set to floppy, CD, DVD, hard disk. Okay, so by default it has taken. So it first searches for floppy. If it is not there, it goes to CD. If it is not there, hard disk. So then next one is acceleration. This is most important. As I told you, Intel and AMD has made it possible as far as the virtualization is concerned. 64 bit and 32 bit. 32 bit has been made as a. So Intel names it as VT slash X or dash X. If the processor is capable, your processor should be capable of virtualization. Okay? There are a number of tools to find out whether your processor is capable of virtualization or not also. Okay? For example, you have gone to your and checked your laptop. It's not allowing because it could be 32 bit or it could be 64 bit, but virtualization layer is not built into processing power or processor. So if your processor says that it is VT-X or AMD-B, that means it is capable of taking virtualization. Otherwise, don't waste your time, it will never boot. Okay? And if you are using Sony laptop, it is capable, but they will disable it. That could also be there. Okay? They don't want you to run the virtualization, even though it is capable, they will disable it. Okay? Unless you flash your BIOS, it is not possible to change this type. Media memory. That means it's the VGA card. 16 MB. Okay? Okay, remote display, desktop server disabled. So this is what another thing. Storage will have the controller. Either IDE controller or SATA controller. Okay, present day it is SATA controller. but it can work with IDE also, that is why it has named as IDE. Okay? And what is the audio? This is what I said, like when I said generic drivers, it is passing on pulse audio, control race, ICH AC97. And it is passing on the network adapter, PCNet, Pass3, NAT, NAT. Understood? That means we have created a hardware which is generic. Okay? Clear? Understood? Next. Now we have to show where is our ISO image. See, we have copied that Windows XP dot ISO into our drive. We are showing the path. Yeah. See here. Normally, we go to BIOS. Pressing delete or F10 while it is booting and change the boot order. This is how to change the boot order. And again, we have an option to increase the base memory or this one. Go to processor also. Here. This is also sometimes important, and VirtualBox is going to give extended features enable PAE or NX. PAE stands for physical address. Execution. If you have a 64 or 32 bit, I said 32 bit can't actually access more than 3.8 GB or something like that. With a PAE, it can access up to 64 GB. Okay? So here, processor, this is a 4 CPU processor. So out of that, we are giving 1 CPU or 1 core. You can increase it, decrease it, even there. Okay.